It's via Zulu army to disband and the warriors permitted to return to their homes. Present military system to be abandoned. New regulations concerning the defense of the realm worked out. All who do not submit will be dealt with as enemies of the crown. We will not permit the arbitrary killing and and unjust oppression which the Zulu people have suffered from their own king, Cetshwayo. You will see from the letter that this ultimatum is our decision alone. Her Majesty's government seems to prefer a negotiated settlement. Does this do what we both know to be right, Frederick?
It does, Sir Henry. Excellently.
Tell the NCO of that black shambles that you love him more than you love me.
Now!
You're not fit to be in the British Army, you different coloured articles. Straighten up! Like a load of bloody earth boys!
I'm to tell you, Corporal, that I love you more than my colour sergeant.
That's frightening. Get out of my bloody sight. Put your rifle over your head and double round this field until you drop bloody dead. Now move, get on with it. On your double. Shut up. Get back in the ranks, you shower of animals.
Coming in. Shoulder. Oh. Present. Oh.
No, what is the time? What do you want? Here, what do you need? Scabble? Yes, scabble. Now, the money, please. No, what about the...
You're stuck and drunk.
You passing through?
We've come to fight the Zulu.
We aren't at war yet. Bit young, isn't he?
It's my nephew. He can shoot, track, and speak Zulu. And fight like hell. He's got Assegai marks to prove it. Track up your information.
You!
Sir!
Take him to the orderly officer.
Colour sergeant. This one.
Thank you.
ship? Who are they?
Sekhale Horse, my lord. Christian Zahl. I know each man by name.
They come well recommended, do they?
My lord, they rode for me at Bushman's Pass.
Oh, indeed. Creelock, we should see that Colonel Dunford has an officer for his hard riders. Perhaps a subaltern from the 24th.
I thought it might be more effective to find someone who speaks Zulu.
Yes. I see you've issued each of them with a Martini Henry carbine. Our quota for native contingents is one rifle to 10 men, and only 5 rounds per rifle.
But will they make good use of them?
They're as good marksmen as horsemen.
There's no doubting their horsemanship, Colonel Danford.
Greylock?
You must think how to make best use of Colonel Danford's African knowledge and experience.
Colonel Danford, William Vereker.
Yes?
I hear you've been seeking officers.
Good ones, yes, Mr. Barrow. Gentlemen who could ride and shoot.
Yabonga.
Mr. Raw, take Mr. Vereker to the store and see he's issued the necessary equipment. And then show him to the mess. And explain to him how an officer is expected to behave.
Our good Colonel Danford's called quite a coup with this Sekhale horse.
There are rumors that my Lord Chelmsford intends to make Danford second in command.
That's typical of Her Majesty's Army. Appoint an engineer to do a soldier's work.
Now, now, Mr. Melville. Less of your spleen.
Stranger in the mess. Gentlemen. My lord. Announce yourself.
Good day, Frederick.
Good day, William. Pleased you could join us.
It was that, or join the Zulu.
Join the Zulu. Oh, yes, you're right in the thick of it, aren't you? Talk to your father before we sailed. He said you had taken to farming near Zululand. Send his regards. Should I meet up with you?
It's nice of the old boy.
I think you'd better call out who you are.
William Vereker.
Sergeant Murphy.
Sir.
Bring drinks for the stranger. Allow me to introduce the mess. Colonel Pulley. Messrs. Melville. Coghill.
Morning.
Jackson. Milne. Major Russell. Stevenson.
How do you do?
Harford. And Harford's best friend.
Don't leave your gin around, Vereker. Or Harford will have it full of preserved butterflies. It's a damn waste if you ask me.
Oh, I doubt if I'll leave much of that around. It's quite a shortage where I've been. They fight with spears, don't they? I mean, it doesn't seem quite fair against the Martini Henry.
You didn't really have to choose between your country and the Zulu, did you?
And a damn close thing it was, too.
Ah, well done, Murphy.
Stranger's cup. Down it in one, and we share your mess bill for a week. And if I don't?
Then a bottle of good claret to each member of the mess is charged to your account.
If it's too much, we can have the bill forwarded to your father. In the House of Lords. Oh, no offense, Medberica.
No offense taken, Melville. To men who aren't afraid to speak their minds.
Good luck, sir.
Of claret are on me, gentlemen.
Regiment!
Regiment!
The regiment. Ngeke babulala abantu ngababekanga icala. Yona ibusa amazwe angamashumi amane. Elikho, elidlula wonke uZulu.
Baba, uyayeka le nje ukukhuluma kanje.
Angisho nini ukuthi angisobe embulala. Ukuthi la mazwe aphuma kumlomo wakhe uShamford ukuqopha. Lala ngabantu bakhe. Nawe imbala. Yobulala ngomthetho nangosiko lakwaZulu. Ngeke ngihlukane namasiko mina. Ngingazange ngiye futhi kwela bamhlophiswa. Ngiyojika imithetho namasiko abo.
Bathi amabutho akho akhula ngobuningi. Ngakho ke. Uthi mangukutshene ukuthi uhlakaze onke amabutho akho manje.
UZulu akaxabene nabamhlophe. Wena-ke manjonga, uma ubhekile ubona la mabutho kwamabutho ahlose ukuyohlasela. Senemela. Hamba kuyamtshela Shamford lowo.
Kuyamtshela. Kodwa ngeke akhole uma ebona izinkulungwane zamabutho ezingamashumi amathathu. Ambomba.
UZulu neka wenqa umngcele. Kodwa uyobheka uqondene naye.
Ungi Lindalala. Joseph, how are all the Colenso girls?
They're all in the garden, sir. And they'll be glad to see you, I'm sure.
Beast!
Out. I did not. William. You cheat, you.
Me cheat? Same old Fanny. Oh.
Welcome. Welcome back.
Excuse me.
Did you get your farm going?
Yes, I did.
How was it?
I've never been so happy.
Sorry you had to leave.
You've met the Honorable William Vereker, I believe.
Yes, Anthony, we were childhood friends.
Your childhood friend shot a dead cow at the gallop the other day. Most impressive.
It isn't Mrs. Danforth, is there?
She exists. Nothing's been heard of her. The 8 years Danforth's been in Africa.
And though much is spoken of her now, my lord.
I recommended him to you. Because he knows Africa so well.
Oh, indeed. His ability to recruit native contingents is proving invaluable to his lordship.
How do you rate him as a soldier?
It is widely held. He has great courage. And he's an excellent engineer.
Shall we join the guests?
She might become interested in someone.
Which one?
Well, that one. The one who keeps looking at
me. Could be your flat yourself, Cargill. It's her odd eye.
They must have locked all the good ones up.
Ah, General. Do you find our border country congenial, my lord?
Landscape most congenial, ma'am. As a border, vulnerable.
Really think Tetsuya will attack us?
The intention of the Zulu Impi and their king concern me deeply, ma'am.
Tetsuya has no intention of attacking Natal, Mrs. Pretorius, unless he's given no option. He has no quarrel with us.
No, rare to meet a young lady interested in tactical matters, Mr. Lindsay.
Was it not, Sir Henry? Most rare.
You are talking of a violent and murdering barbarian who commands an army of 30,000 warriors just across the river.
My father has known and lived with the Zulus for many years.
Cetshwayo massacred 20,000 of his own people to make himself king.
The English Tudor kings did no less. Much later in our nation's history, I might add, and the French much more recently.
That may well be, Your Grace, but be that as it may, my duty is clear. The defense of all this, Natal.
Yes. Well, it's difficult to stand against that position. If you speak only of defense.
And what does our good Colonel Durnford think?
If the people of Natal wish to feel safe, let them persuade their husbands and sons to come forward and volunteer. We need both officers and men.
We do, Colonel. Good point.
I cannot be brought to believe that Cetshwayo wants a war with Britain.
Every Zulu is raised to be a warrior. Without a war, there'd be no Zulu nation.
Nobody is really safe, are they, Your Excellency?
Mrs. DeWitt has four daughters, Henry, and I fear she feels for them all.
Your daughters may indeed be in some danger, Mrs. DeWitt, but not at the moment from the Zulus, eh?
Thank you.
and gentlemen. Your attention, please. I think I should inform you that I am obliged to issue a notification declaring a state of war between Her Majesty's government and the Zulu King, Tetswayo, on his non-compliance with the ultimatum made on him, urging reparation and redress for violations of British sovereignty.
Why? Why do men think of nothing but killing?
Wonderful land you are privileged to share. Dear God, there should be room for all of us.
There goes number two company. Quartermaster?
Quartermaster.
Do I believe what may I see? The whole bleeding army moving off to meet the murdering heathen, and what goes on in here? A game of brag. Brag?
Oh, sorry, quartermaster.
You'll be more sorrier still when the Zulu asks, lad, what have you got to offer me not to slit your gut? And you say, art the knave of art, sir. The knave of art.
Move.
For a savage, as for a child, chastisement is sometimes a kindness.
Let us hope, Jim, that this will be the final solution to the Zulu problem.
Prepared a list of ideas for you to see.
Excellent, thank you. Give them the cleanup, would you?
My lord, this list was prepared for you. I don't think another can understand its true value.
Thank you, Colonel Durfin. Gentlemen, within 10 days we shall cross the Buffalo River and British soldiers will then be in Zululand. Colonel Durfin will remain downriver, where he'll be responsible for the defense of the Natal border.
Were you real off post, sir?
I listened extra careful to your stand, too, this morning, boy. It was perfect. Couldn't have done it better myself. Not even when I was bugler at the Duke of Wellington. So tell me, where'd you get that black eye?
From the cook, sir. Well, they saw me dip your shaving tin in the tea water this morning. My dear tea tasted like a toilet soap, they said.
So, we got in the line of duty. Point taken.
Will we be fighting the Zulu soon, quartermaster?
Could be. I'm
cross the river into Zulu land. Might just be waiting there for us to show up. Them stabbing assy guys pointing right at our bellies.
You afraid of a Zulu then, quartermaster?
One Zulu is only one man. And I'm afraid of no one man. But the Zulu may come in the thousands. Like a black wave of death in the thousands. Them assy guys stabbing.
Your orders, Mr. Verrett.
I'm to take the Sicali with the main column to the river.
Lord Chelmsford seems to want me to stay back with my pursuers.
I think Chelmsford wants a good man on the border. He fears a flanking attack and requires a steady commander in reserve.
The wrong side of the river, the wrong place. Does he wish me to fight the Zulu or merely observe their natural habitat?
Sir.
Go with you, Mr. Merrick.
Thank you.
You think Chet Square will send a party to greet you, Mr. Vericup?
Well, they're here all right. Just have to make sure they don't get back to announce us.
You mean you've seen them?
Strange name the newspaper chap's called.
They're called Nog, sir. Actual name is Norris Newman. He presented credentials from the Standard.
Our runners bear his dispatches, do they not?
Of course, sir.
Historical moment, gentlemen.
Excuse me, my lord. Norris Newman of the Standard, my lord.
I saw you lead our cavalry, sir.
Indeed, I did, my lord. I was one of the first to cross.
Were they in good heart as they entered enemy territory?
They spurred onto the high ground, my lord, full of spirit and looking for the Zulu. Full of sport they were, my lord.
Tell what you see. Write it well, sir. And make sure you get it right.
If I got it right, my lord, you lead an invasion into Zululand, for I see it all around me. But why is the question my readers will ask? Why?
Do not confuse yourself. Why? We must strike a heavy blow. This cannot be a war of maneuver.
So, attack is your defense. Well, let's hope Chetsweo will offer his impis for destruction.
My only fear is that the Zulu will avoid engagement.
I have it, my lord. We attack for sport. Or is it reputations?
Enough of your politicking, Noggs.
I know your views on the usefulness of the press, my lord, but the Englishman back home wants to know what his regiments are doing.
Then I trust you will tell him exactly what you have observed.
Bloomfield. Look at that waste. Five rounds ruined, Mr. Arthur. Each round has to be accounted for. It's terrible. Quite dreadful. Something's been done.
If they've been put back in their boxes. Boxes banded and screwed down proper-like. As his lordship ordered. Nothing would have happened to them, sir.
I'm talking about our drowned natives, quartermaster.
Natives is not on my invoices, Mr. Harford. Ammunition is, and has to be accounted for. And the brass cartridge case is returned.
Several of our natives went under. Shouldn't we have a roll call, Colonel?
Not practical, lad. We haven't had time to make up the rolls yet. Besides, I'm not sure how many we had before the crossing.
Mr. Melville.
Come here by the orders of the great Queen Victoria, Queen of all Africa.
Major, send the troops.
Took him with the down.
Well, this one's a grandfather, at least. If he'd been a Zulu in his prime, I'd have given odds against your lancer, Mr. Melville.
Well, gentlemen, first blood to us. And a rousing good report in the newspapers to satisfy the politicians, eh?
Abantu akamjukona kanjaba. Njengoba sazi sonke ukuthi sekuyisikhathi sokuvuna. Aphamba siqala ukuvuna. yasithola ukuthi kukhona okufanele masikwenze. Induna enkulu ebamhlophe uShamford sengichuluze kakhulu. Angiboni ukukhona okunye singakwenza ngaphandle ukuba sivikele izwe lethu.
Ready to move out, Colonel. My lord, I prepared to move on to
your destination, Colonel.
Is San Luana. 4 miles further than that tallest hill. Follow the track, and it will lead us to the slopes of the mountain.
Isa Luana.
Yes. Isa Luana.
It's an extended line, quartermaster, but not too extended, or my company can't protect them. No more than 50 feet between each one.
Stop!
Put them too close together, the stupid things will walk into each other. You can sit on your ass for a good 4 hours.
Company house! Keep them ways moving! No more than 50 feet! Keep them moving! Keep them moving!
There, Melvin. There, stretched out, is my Lord Chelmsford's army. What a wonderful adventure we undertake. What a marvelous spree.
Hey, Umfang! Where's the lava? Come here, sir!
Elephant, it's on your dam! I'm at the city bomb!
Eufan! Otalapa! Eufan! Otalapa! Come so man!
Commissari non incomo, ma fai una zessa incomo, Cesari!
I'm ill. Dozens of Zulus followed me. I must have shot 5, 6, 10, I lost count. They just kept coming. Blood curdling swine.
Why did they attack you?
I discovered the army, Your Honor. A valley full of them, and beyond.
Army? What army?
Beyond them hills, sir, and coming this way.
Mr. Vereker, would you mind my asking you to take a look at this map?
By all means, Colonel.
You see?
Your wagons, Colonel.
What about my wagon?
On an open slope like this, you must bring your wagons round and form them into a lager. And that immediately.
I hear you have prisoners, Colonel. Well done. Evening, William.
Thank you, sir.
Good evening, Frederick. I think you should hear this. What do you think you were saying? Your brother didn't lager his camp, and...
They had 73 in their party. We found 73 skeletons 6 months later.
Boers require a lager with only a few wagons. We have many. An unassailable square of British firepower is a defense which can be formed in a moment. You're leaving us, Master Boer?
I'm going to camp among the rocks over there.
Now, my lord, Mr. Fanning, I claim to have seen a Zulu impi some few thousand or so exactly here in this valley.
Unlikely. Most unlikely. It would mean taking 24,000 men over mountaintops. This is not helpful. Have the prisoners brought to my cabin.
All right, Corporal. Anything?
No, sir. Now,
get out.
Now, be sensible, man. Tell us.
Evening. Dirty work, eh?
Very dirty.
Sibaleke empini enkulu esempumalanga salandela lo mlungu ukuba asikhombe ibutho leni ukuthi sizozinikela.
What did they say?
Claim they're deserters from the main imp is in the east. Followed this one so they could give themselves up. Go home.
Do you believe that?
Oh, their bodies are well oiled, they're fed regularly. It's unlikely if they're the fugitives, they say.
Have them question further. They claim the Zulu impis are east towards the Royal Kraal, and yet this fellow says they are further towards the north.
Where that they are, your worship, there are 60,000 or more.
They multiply, Mr. Fanning. You do speak the Zulu tongue, do you? Now, tomorrow I intend to find the Zulu impi, Mr. Fanning, and you will accompany me.
I'm no soldier, Your Honor, and it's further into Zululand.
You will accompany me, Mr. Fanning, or you will be arrested.
This way, Mr. Fanning.
Prelock. We have scouts out in the direction he claims he saw the Zulus?
Of course, sir.
And?
The only reports of enemy activity have come from the direction of the Royal Kraal. At Ulundi.
Thank you.
Why don't the Zulus attack?
Zulu? May not wear shoes or trousers and the like. I don't mean to say they got no brains.
Watch us and wait.
Find our weaknesses.
Have we weaknesses, quartermaster?
Peace off, I never heard nothing. I don't think.
Well, I did. Stand to. Stand to.
Stand to, Callison.
Who gave the order?
Private Williamson.
I've got to see this. Did you call stand to, Private Williams?
I didn't hear nothing, sir.
Well, stand to, damn you!
Now, you've done well for once. Don't push your luck.
I heard him first.
I'll get you a medal for modesty, Private Williams. Would you like that?
You never would, Colour Sergeant. A medal.
Colonel Dunford here.
Easy, lads. Just
Please follow the track, sir. You'll come to Lord Chelmsford's headquarters.
Sergeant.
Stand down, lads.
You've done well. Keep it up, lad. Keep it up.
Intended to bring your reserves across the river. I have received intelligence from sources of my own that the Zulu impis are moving north of you to threaten your left.
Intelligence? Sources of your own? Did it not occur to you there may be native rumors? Rumors to draw you off, to leave the whole of Natal open to a possible counter-thrust?
Kitshwayo wants a head-on battle, a decisive victory, so that his people can get on with the one matter that is life and death for his nation, their delayed harvest.
Are you dictating the strategy of this war, sir?
I'm explaining my reasons.
Yes?
A large party of Zulus have been sighted in the direction of the King's kraal.
Tomorrow we will continue our advance on Ulundi. Danford, kindly return to your unit. Bring them here immediately to support Pauline. Mr. Vareker will join you as ADC. Do you understand me clearly?
And the threat of counter-invasion no longer exists?
Colonel, if on another occasion you flout my direct orders, I shall reluctantly relieve you of your command.
Perhaps he has thought to conquer Zululand on his own, my lord.
I trust you to keep me well informed of Colonel Danford and his men when they arrive, William.
Certainly, sir.
Gentlemen, we move to find camp and engage the enemy. And my nose tells me we may make early contact.
Mr. Melville, until the reinforcement arrives, we will stand to.
Sir.
Dougla, start the fall in.
To keep an eye on. Would you mind riding over to Stuart Smith, ask him to bring his artillery about?
Sir. Oh, Mr. Melville, kindly send a lookout. Tell him to call out the instant he spies Colonel Danford's column coming to reinforce us.
Stuart!
Yes?
How quickly can you move your artillery forward?
Well, my horses are feeding, as you may observe, Mr. Coghill. It'll take a little while.
Well, fed or hungry, Pauline wants them in position immediately.
Right. Bombardier, to me, please.
Let's go!
What o'clock is it, Mr. Knox?
11 o'clock, my lord.
Our friend Colonel Durnford will be... should be at this minute approaching Pauline. I think we'll eat here. I want to scout that mountain top and be back with an appetite in 1 hour.
Sir.
Void. Young Israel, so be able to Lord. Malizala, old care, says what?
Bulalana Batagat! Bulalana Batagat! Bulalana Batagat!
I'll fix it, sir.
Bulalana Batagat! Bulalana Batagat!
Shut that yelling up! You hear me?
Bulalana Batagat!
Did you hear me? Shut up!
That is Gandhi's. Sit down.
Shush, Andrew.
Pause, pause.
Exceedingly pleased to greet you, sir.
Colonel, I see you're standing too. Perhaps the men could eat with their equipment unbuckled.
Yes, of course. Excellent idea. Good. Mr. Melville, order stand down, will you?
Sir.
Please.
Sergeant! Stand the men down, would you?
Treelock, old fella. I'm doing notes for my dispatch, and I need to clear up a few military points. I don't want to bother his lordship. Had it drummed into my thick skull that a good commander never willingly splits his force, especially in an enemy's country, before knowing their disposition?
Yes, if we were facing a European enemy armed with guns, I think your point would hold, Noggs. Further, may I remind you, I do not create the strategies you wish to comment on. I'm only his lordship's secretary.
I wouldn't take overly comfort from that, Creelock, old fellow. Because if he sinks, then you sink with him.
So, you've been asked to look after me, Lieutenant.
I assure you, sir, I have no desire to create difficulties.
And I assure you, you do not. In fact, I'd be obliged for your best advice. What have your scouts seen?
So far, only their scouts. But we have had reports of a small impi further north, over there.
His lordship is of the certain opinion, and it's far too difficult an approach to be chosen by the Zulu command.
Yes, well... difficulty never deterred a Zulu commander. How many?
We don't know.
think it would be wise to pick at the hints. Just in case.
Ngithikhwelisa lezi zinkomo endleleni.
Just managed to bring down a boy of 12.
Chelmsford. Inform his lordship we've found what he's looking for.
Yes, sir.
Tell me the Zulu managed to get up there after all.
Zulu!
They're here! I've sent to Lord Chelmsford.
Bugler, sound the alert.
private story. Keep those raised markers, Painter, at the double.
Sarge.
One every 100 yards.
Come on, boy, scamper.
And bugler, make sure he pegs them in a straight line towards the enemy.
Hold them. Please, God. 3 minutes. Please, hold them. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, men.
92, 93, 94, 96, 97, 98, 99. What's next, boy?
Oi, you useless little bastard. Come here, scamper.
Look. Look.
Lock splendid. I want to establish camp here immediately.
Certainly, sir.
After lunch, Brown, I want you to return to Isandhwana and instruct Colonel Pullin to join us here immediately.
If you'll excuse me, my lord.
No appetite, Colonel?
My men haven't eaten since yesterday, and there won't be any supplies until I get them back to Isandhwana.
Then they can start off now, and you can join them when you've eaten.
Kind of you, my lord. But I don't think it would be proper for me to sit at your table. They with their bellies stuck to their backbones.
Excuse me, sir.
Learn nothing from that Irishman, Harford. Except how not to behave.
Strange message from Vereker, my lord. It would seem that Pullin has a battle on his hands. No details. No intelligence.
Mr. Milne, kindly take your telescope to a high point. Note the events at Isandhwana.
Sir.
ride to Lord Chelmsford. He'll find it for the Lundy. Tell him the battle he longs for has started and needs to move here quickly. Am I clear?
Yes, Colonel! Number one gun!
Grab that. Come on.
Where are you going?
Oh, bugger that.
Come on.
Watching our bloody markers.
Come on, sunshine.
Oh, no. Come all this bloody way to get shot by a bullet from Birmingham.
Shoot straight, you bastards! Check your eyes!
Ride to Stuart Smith. Let his guns cover Durnford for a fallback.
Yes, sir. Chicali, follow me!
Can you give me some covering fire for Durnford on the right flank?
Number two guns, keep fire, hold section right!
Against the bone, smash them out.
But bullets run out.
and those that his spears don't.
Holland! Not issue ammunition from this wagon to any but authorized companies. This lot have their own.
Can tell you have the billion leads as them.
Get your own wagon. Amber! Zaya!
How long have we got to wait, quartermaster?
Get back in line, boy. Wait your turn.
But sir.
Move!
We're pulling.
Look, it ain't my fault. All the tops are screwed down.
Come on, I'm waiting.
I've watched the camp for 20 minutes. The haze obscures much. The tents have not been struck. The only thing I could distinguish is the wagons have been moved en masse into the camp.
Thank you, Mr. Mill. Inform Colonel Creelock, would you?
Sir.
Thank you, Milne.
The camp is under attack from a large force of Zulu. Colonel Pauline sends for help.
Calm yourself, Mr. Harford. Where do you come by this intelligence?
Danvers Carbonier himself rode from the camp.
Very well, go on.
Colonel Harness has already turned with the artillery.
He has. I see. Ride after Lord Chancellor and acquaint him with your intelligence.
And Mr. Harford! Control your passions.
A professional soldier must keep cool and thoughtful in times of stress.
Thank you. bloody turret and get in line!
Come on, boy!
Goodbye, lad. Come on! Sergeant!
Gentlemen, it's time to save the colors. Get to Rourke's drift. You must warm them. The colors. Carry them to safety, Mr. Melville.
Sir.
You go.
Sergeant, you're to ride back to the town. When you see the bishop, tell him. Let me tell his daughter. I was obliged to remain here with my infantry. Now go. God go with you.
I leave God Jesus with you.
Thank you.
Excuse me, my lord. There's something I must convey to you. I rode a little way along the track to Rourke's Drift. The sky above is red with fire. Your orders, my lord. Do we move to the drift?